Hello, I'm Chris Woods, Incident Commander Trainee with the Eastern Area Gold Team, coming at you from Orleans, California on the 2023 SRF Lighting Complex, and we'd like to share a success story with you. Prior to our team's arrival, Six Rivers National Forest leadership, in conjunction with previous incident management teams, were able to develop a strategic firing operation. Our Eastern Area Gold Team was fortunate to carry out this operation. And of note is how well this strategy aligned with Chief Moore's wildfire letter of intent. We were able to protect critical values, reduce future wildfire impacts to both firefighter safety and threatened communities, and we're able to introduce healthy fire to a fire-dependent landscape. None of this would have been possible without close collaboration with local tribes, communities, and partners.
I'm Alan Briggs, one of the operations section chiefs for the Eastern Area Gold Team. Our role here with this incident was to allocate resources according to the leader's intent, letters of delegation that were given to us by the agency administrators. Timing and seasonality have a lot to do with how successful we were on this incident. We just happened to be in the right place at the right time with some very forward-thinking people when the strategy was put together. What's great about what we've been able to accomplish here is we took that mindset in consultation and we developed the overall strategy of containing, right? Because our main objective was the safety and welfare of the firefighters and the public. How do you accomplish that? You look at the overall big picture and you say, you know, based on weather and forecasts and fire behavior, the abilities and of the folks that are actually on the incident, and you develop that strategy of when, where, and how. And with the overall objective of keeping the community safe. And then also with this, it was important to realize that the investments made in this strategy being successful was a reduction in fuels on the landscape at a landscape scale that would reduce future risk to that community. One of the tools that we utilized on this fire that was extremely helpful in our success was UAS. And so other folks may know that as drones. It was a major tool in the toolbox. It's not the only tool. A lot of what we do, the fire dictates to the team when we're developing our strategy. I think we had a very successful operation that was strategically thought about and tactically implemented on a landscape scale. And featuring that out, the science that we collected and will continue to collect will be crucial as to whether or not what we feel was a short-term success will be a long-term success on the landscape. I believe that it will be. Is this the end-all strategy for every fire in the future? I would say no. Is this a strategy that we could use in the future that we can learn from? Yes, we can. And I think we should as an agency, as a whole. I think what we did here was unique. What would be ideal is if it wasn't unique.
My name is Todd Wood. I'm Division Oscar on the SRF Lighting Complex, Northern California. I supervise a specific chunk of land on the fire and all the resources and all the fire that occur within those division rigs. On this division, I'm given a task, a purpose, and an end state. The task was to stop wildland fire spread and to put good fire on the ground to return the ecosystem to a more natural fuel loading. The way we accomplish this mission is come out, set up with some defined strategies and tactics of how we're going to introduce fire onto the landscape to maintain our holding lines and to also not introduce extreme fire behavior. With that, we use hotshot crews, we use hand crews, we use fire engines, and all of those come together to introduce fire off of the firing line and also to put fire interior and try and get moderate low intensity fire in there, just reducing the fuel loading, defeating the fire from making large runs that produce catastrophic results. On this particular fire, we also tried to introduce historical burning. We have several tribes in the area that have lived here for several thousand years. They did burning in here to maintain the landscape for their livelihood.
Aiki, my name is Gene Riot. I'm a local firefighter with the tribal crew, Karuk 1 Fire Module. My crew just scouted a lot of the mountain and the ridges and ran fire with it, took what it gave us. It just broke into three segments, had a hotshot crew over here, my crew in the middle, another crew over here, and we kind of brought it down from the tops of the mountains, slowly down to the road, evenly, nice slow burn to save as many trees as we could. And this burn was kind of different. We were trying to take care of the land in a good way and get it burnt in a manner where it'll help us in the future by incorporating our traditional ways with how we fire the ridges. The new ways of how they fire kind of brought them together, and it worked out great. As a firing trainee, I worked with the PSD guys, their squad, and basically kind of looked at the map, worked with them, and we placed where we wanted the machine to go and get our good strip with good effects, and that worked great. Worked as a team. Yeah, just a lot of reading the map, walking the land, trying to get the good effects, and yeah, it was a good deal. I was real proud about how it went and how the Forest Service and the tribe, they worked together, got it done. Yeah, a lot of people look at fire as like a big dangerous thing, but it can also be a tool, and it's a great way to take care of the area. And there's a lot of species of plants and trees out there that actually depend on fire. Instead of just suppressing the fires, we could use it as a tool, and it actually benefits the land, the people. And yeah, I'd like to see things get back to that, which I think we're on the track now. We're kind of, it's a big team effort between a lot of agencies, including the local tribes, and yeah, it's awesome. It's a job you can be proud of. I'm actually extra proud because I get to work with my local tribe, and that's awesome. Yeah, I'm super proud of it. I don't think I'll be going anywhere anytime soon.
My name is Maris Gablix. I'm an incident commander trainee with the Eastern Area Gold Team. We'd like to thank the Six Rivers National Forest for hosting us here during our firefighting assignment. We're also honored to be part of the strategic firefighting operations that were used here to fight these wildfires, protect the community of Orleans, while also promoting the resiliency of our forests. We look forward to the future where more fire assignments allow us to use fire in fighting fires when weather, conditions, and seasonality allow.